Good evening, church. You're welcome to Highland Church, and it's our midweek service, tagged Hour of Grace and Communion Service. With me on set today is Bro Tolu.
Good evening, Star. Good evening, everyone. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome, sir. Bro Tolu, it's good to see you this evening. Okay, we have some questions that we want some answers from you.
Okay.
So let's shoot without much ado.
Yes, please.
The first question is, how long have you been with this ministry? And can you share with us some of the wondrous things God has done for you as a person and in your family?
Wow. Okay, so I joined this ministry in the year 2005. And that was when I was still out of school and expecting my admission. And I think from 2005 to date, we'll be going to about 16 years. And God has really done wondrous things, you know, in my life, you know, in every area of my life. Talking about my career. So from the word that came from the pulpit, from the man of God, strong words that pushed us, you know, and pushed me to excellence, went on to write my ICAN exams, passed all levels at first sitting, went on to, you know, for my admission in the school, came out at the top of the class, got job offers in multinational companies, even got married in the ministry with kids. It's just been one level from glory to glory. And I appreciate God for placing me and positioning me in this ministry.
Wow. That's beautiful. 15 years in this ministry. Yeah. That means you have a lot to tell us. You could tell us a lot about ministry.
Yes.
Okay, so I think that should move us to our next question. In this ministry, we have about 5 pillars that guide our actions. Can you please share with us any two of the 5 pillars?
Okay, like you said, 5 pillars. Two that stand out for me is, one is Highland Church is a grace church. And for me, one of the words that is strong and the message from that that pillar is Acts chapter 20, verse 32 for me, which says, you know, and brethren, I commend you unto the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and give an inheritance among those who are sanctified. You know, the word has always come strongly in this ministry. And most of us that have been here for a long time, we know that we have been made by words. You know, the words have formed us. The grace of God that has come out from the word has really transformed us to be the people we are, you know, where we are manifesting to our world. And, you know, I want to appreciate God for that. And I believe that that pillar is manifesting in the lives of people that joined to Highland Church. The second pillar for me is we are a global church. You know, and for me, the rema in that pillar is Isaiah chapter 2, verse 2, that says, and it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord shall be established on the top of the mountains and exalted over the hills, and the nations, all nations shall flow into it. So he's saying that Highland Church will be a place where all nations of the world will be ready to receive the word that comes out of Highland Church. Will be people that matter, people that bring relevance, people that when we say a word, the world is ready to listen to us. We are manifesting to our world. And for me, those two pillars are very strong, and they are the pillars that I think I hold dearly, you know, among the 5 pillars, of which the other 3, of course, are also important. But for me, those two stand out for me.
So we could see those two as probably your rema that you are running with.
Yes.
The Bible said all nations will flow into it. That means there are no barriers.
No barriers.
No limits. Distance. Mm-hmm. No limitation.
True.
That's beautiful.
Hallelujah.
Recently, you know, since COVID-19 eruption and what have you, it's been social distancing, and we are also told that we should not come together to worship. And like the scripture says that we should not forsake the assemblies of ourselves together. Now, there is no physical coming together to worship. How has the online service of Highland Church, how has it been a blessing to you?
Wow. I love this question because I would say since the beginning of the pandemic, the ministry has continued to hold services online, and the words that have been coming out has actually been very powerful. You know, and we talk about, I know we're in the series talking about it is time. It's a time to take action. It's time to shine. You know, it's our time of manifestation. And those words are rema. Yeah. And what I just say to people that think, okay, why should I join online? is that there is no distance in the realm of the spirit. If you look at the Bible, Luke chapter 7, you know, when Jesus was talking to the centurion, and he wanted to go to the house to heal the centurion servant, he said, no, don't worry, just speak the word. And at that hour, when Jesus spoke the word, the centurion servant was made whole. You know, so there is no distance in the realm of the spirit. Even in our, even in the science world, we see what happens even just to put in your POS machine to pay, get payment. There's a lot of things that happen in the back end. Talk more of something that is more spiritual. So I want to encourage us, you know, spend more time, receive God's word, and believe God's word even as it comes forth, even via the online media.
Thank you very much, Bratolu. You know, I caught something when you were talking, that scripture that you quoted. That means online services and online miracles has been in existence even before COVID-19.
True.
You know, just speak the word.
Yes.
So right where we are in our homes, in the comfort of our homes, you can receive our miracle.
Receive your rhema.
Wow, that's a rhema. That's a rhema. Okay, another question is, what do you have for our viewers and listeners at home who, you know, some still think that you can't really get much from God through these online services? What do you have for them? How can you encourage some of them who still feel, you know, distractions and what have you when you're at home and you're not there physically? What do you have for our viewers?
Okay. I would encourage them once again, you know, to go and just follow us, follow the word. Follow the undiluted word that is going forth, you know, at every service that we hold. You know, like a man of God said, he says, you know, using Psalm 23, verse 2, you know, the Lord, verse 1 says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He said, he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. You know, talking about when the land is green, when the grass is green, the sheep will always gather. Highland Church is a place where the word is strong. The word comes out undiluted. The grass is always green. And we have been there, you know, gathering there to receive the word on a constant basis. And our lives have been changed. So I'll just enjoin members, don't get discouraged. Join us for service. Receive the word. Run with that word. And you manifest it in Jesus' name.
Amen. Before you go this evening, we have just one more question for you. Okay, at Highland Church, we hold our services weekly and what have you. Please, what day and time does Highland Church hold our services online?
Okay, so for benefit of those that don't know, Highland Church holds its services on weekdays, and that's our midweek service, which holds on Thursday by 6 p.m., and also our celebration service that comes up at 9 a.m. on Sundays. We would like to see you. We would like to be part of you. We would like you to join us on our various media platforms. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Bratolu.
Thank you
for accepting our invitation to be our guest this evening. We hope that next time that we call on you, you won't hesitate to us.
We are always available.
Thank you very much. God bless you. Okay, to our viewers and our listeners, yeah, we are mentioning listener because we know we have some who are watching or listening to us on MixLR. You have heard it all from Bratolu. He has shared some of the things that God has done for him. And he has also told us that there is no barrier in the realm of the spirit. You just speak like that centurion also. Tell it to God, that God, speak to me, and everything I've been trusting you for will manifest. It is time for action. War your prophecies into action, and you'll be amazed at how God will come true for you. And I pray that very soon you'll be a testifier in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.